هاي ويلكم تو ذا ان اكس كورس ان اكس كام كورس. توداي ويل سبيك اباوت ذا ستيبس اوف ان اكس كام. ليتس تراي اون ذيس بارت تو اكسبلين ذا فول ستيبس اوف هاو تو ميك مانيفاكتشرنج بروجرام اون ذا يوني جرافيكس ان اكس. ذا فيرست ستيب ذات وي ار ميكينج ذات to enter the application of the CAM from application manufacturing. This is the first step to change the interface from the CAD to AutoCAD to CAM or manufacturing. Okay, here we can choose mill planner or mill contour. It's okay, and I can change also inside the CAM. Okay. The second step that we have here, now I have the interface of the manufacturing. Okay, I have here operation navigator. This operation navigator to see what I did in the operation or in the program. Okay, the steps that I did. Okay, here for the program, program order. Here, machine tool view. To see the tools that I have here, the geometry to see the axis and the workpiece. Okay, here the method, machining method view to see what is the operation, the rough operation, what is the semi finish operation, what is the finish operation. Okay, the first step inside the manufacturing application is to define the workpiece. How to define the workpiece? Double click here in the workpiece. You will see specify part and specify blank. Specify part, this is the part that we need, the final part that we need, the final surface. Okay, here I will select. Okay, now if this display, this means that I choose the part. Okay. What is the blank? The blank is the raw material, the initial part that that will be in the machine. The initial raw material that that will be changed to be the final part. Okay. We have different methods to make the blank. Geometry. If I have geometry ready, I already did model for the blank. I will choose select. The second. Offset from part. If I have, if I will give it number, this is the offset. What mean by offset? That it will be the blank will be the same part, but with more than with more offset. Okay, okay. Bounding block. Bounding block. As you see, the program make block just in the outline of the part. Like what we see, and I can control like this. Okay, this is the plank that we will do. We have bounding also cylinder if I need to make, but this is for sure it cannot be applicable with this part. Maybe if I have a cylinder part or something, it can be okay. Now I will choose the bounding block, and I will increase the height a little bit. So I have the initial part here, and this is the plank. Okay, okay. I will choose. Now I specify the part and the plank as you see. Okay. Here I'm changing the material: carbon steel, alloy steel, whatever you want, and it's okay. Now I did the second step as a general, the first step to be in the CAM application, and the second step to define the workpiece. Define the workpiece means that you will define the part and the plank. Okay, I will create the tool. I have also two options to create the tool. The first option to create tool, to choose and then to define the the dimensions. Okay, if you know specific dimension for the tool, you will do by yourself. And the tool number, to define the tool number, 2B1 for example, and the material high speed steel. Okay, this is the first method to create tool. Okay, I have another method to create tool. Let's try retrieve tool from library. We have option to retrieve tool from library. Okay, milling and mill. It's okay. Here you can search by equal 10 and okay. You will have all the end mill that have diameter 10. You can search also by bigger than or lower than, like this. You will see all that bigger than. Okay, so now we create a tool in which view the tool will be shown. Here machine tool view, this is the end mill that I did. Okay, I can create another tool for the finish, and let's choose the ball mill. The ball mill with diameter 15. Okay, and the length and tool number, let's be 2. Okay, here I need drilling, also drilling tools, create tool. Here I will choose hole making. Hole making, it will convert the interface to the drilling tools. Okay, I will select central drill. Central drill to only mark the center. Okay, and then okay. Here I will make it okay, 10, then okay. The last one that I will do, the drill tool that I will make drilling by, and make it 14 or 15 like the hole, and it will be okay. Now I created the four tools that I will use in this program. Okay, let's we did two steps inside the manufacturing. We did two steps. The first step to define the workpiece, the second step to define the tools. Okay, let's go to the third step, create operation. Let's start by mill contour. Today in this lecture I just want to see the general steps. Okay, let's try one operation from the mill contour. This is the rough operation. The rough operation, I will define the program. Here the tool, you will use the mill in the first operation. Here geometry, we define the workpiece. Here it will be mill rough, and I will press OK. Now you can make generate. It's generate the tool pass, and we can see generate, it's done already the tool pass that you need. Okay, but I can control what these options. Percent of flat, step over. What is the step over? Step over, we need to show the tool pass. We need to see the tool pass. If you see now the tool pass, it will make something like this. Then this is the step over. So if I made it 30%, it will be more tool pass. As you see, if I made it 20, it will be more tool pass. So it is okay now. Okay, what is the depth per cut? Depth per cut is the other direction. This here, the depth per cut is 6. If I need to make it 2, it will be more cut levels. Okay. From here cut levels, I can control more control for the cut levels. From here more control the cut we will know all of this in the details sessions. Okay, cutting parameters, this is the parameter that can make more control in the cutting moves, like this cyan color, we can control this. And the non-cutting moves, this is the red and the blue and yellow moves. we can control also this distance to make it higher, to make it lower, whatever we want in this, we will take it later. Feed and speed, you can control also the speed and feed of the program. Okay, now we finished the first operation. The first operation, cavity mill inside the tool that I created. And if you have also the geometry here, you will find the cavity mill. Okay, I can make double click again to open and make something like verify. What mean by verify? Verify, you will see the cut movement. Okay, here I will make 3D dynamic display option, make it fine, and then tool pass. Okay, it's okay here, fine, and then let's see what happened. You will click play. This is the animation speed. You can reduce. You will see the cutting move. It's okay. This is the rough operation. And you see it's finished pass by pass, level, and then go to the lower level. You can make rotate to see what happened. It's okay, this is the first operation. And it will make the bucket. Yes, correct. It's okay. Now I did the first operation. Okay, I can also see the post process. What mean by post process? Post process, this is the G code. I can extract the G code MIL3X. Here browse to an output. Okay, I can make it in the desktop. Okay, we can see here the G code. We can extract the G code of this operation. Now what we see, this is the G code. T1, this is the tool number one that we defined, and M6, and this is the G code that you will put inside the machine to generate this cutting. Okay, this is the first operation. Let us make the second operation. This is the finish operation. We will try another operation called rest milling. This is finish operation. I will change to be pole mill, then work piece, then mill finish. It's okay. The same options, you will see the same options. I can change this. This is the cut pattern. We can make zigzag. We can make zig to cut in one direction, zigzag to cut in two direction. Okay, let us follow this cut pattern. And this to be okay, 10%, because it's finished, so I need to reduce. And then generate. We will see that it will make okay. Yeah. What is this error? This error, some region will be ignored because they are too small. Okay, for sure it means that the four holes that we will make later. Okay, this is the finish operations. Okay, now I did two operations. Why this operation is like this with green, green mark, and then this with this mark? This means that here I extracted the G code. I did post process here. I didn't make the post process. If I did post process like the other, it will be the same symbol. Okay, I can be here in the workpiece and make post process to show to see the two operations in one G code. Okay, let's make the drilling. I will create operation. Here I will change to be hole making. It will be the interface of the drilling. I will make spot drilling to just mark the center and then the drilling. Okay, spot drilling. I did center drill, the center drill tool, then drill method. Okay. Here specify feature geometry. I will specify the holes. The second, the third. Oh, this is the list of the four holes that I choose. Okay, then I can make generate. You will see that it will just make mark on the center. And okay, this is the third operation. The last operation is the drilling operation. We'll use the other standard drill and then okay, and the same sequence. We will choose the drilling holes. Okay, generate. You will see that this will make the four. Okay, if we need to show the all operations together, we can select the workpiece and then verify. Verify means that you will see display option, fine, the same, and here fine, and then play. This is the first operation. As we see, this is the first operation. I did the animation is speed to be 9 to be very fast. It's okay. Level by level. Let's remove level by level. The 2 millimeters that we change, that we did. This is the 2 millimeters that change. Yes, it's okay. This is the first operation. It's done already. You will see the second operation that by another color now. Yes, this is the second operation. As we see, this is the finish operation. Okay, if you notice now, we have this material. We have this material left with a we need another operation to make this material. Okay, this we will know all of this, how to make the remaining material in the next sessions. Let us continue. Yes, it's okay. This is the remaining, and then the spot, and then the drilling if we know. It's okay. We have option to show thickness by color. This option is very good for to see what is the remaining material that you need to remove. This show thickness by color. It will make analysis for the part to just check. Yes, as you see here, if you clicked, you will see 1.8 material remaining. Here 2.4. It's very. We have 2.5. Or 2.4 thickness. Here you will be it's already good. Here it is very good, as you see. Here it is very good. So this analysis to see what is the remaining material in your part. Okay. Now I finished all these operations, the four operations, and this was to just know the steps that we are following inside the NXCAM. And now we will make the last one that we did already. This, oh, it's okay. To see, now I selected the workpiece, so you will see all the four operation. This is the four operation. This is T1, and if you go down, okay, the first operation, then the second. Here it is T2, so this is the change of the operation. Here from here this is the second operation, and then the third and the last operation. Okay, now I finish this. I have another option called shop documentation. Shop documentation, this is browse, make browse also at desktop. This shop documentation, we can see report by the four operations, all operations that we saw with the parameters that we did. So okay, this is the report, something like report. Okay, now we finished all these operations and we finished the general steps in the NXCAM. Next lessons or next sessions, we will go inside these parameters. We will go deep inside these parameters. Okay, we will open these to know what is this, and to open cutting parameters to see all of this. What is the connections? What is the stock? What is the corner? The most important parameters that we will use. Okay, now the last step is to make simulation to see the machine with the part. Now we did just verification to see the tool with the part. Okay, now we will go to machine tool view, generic machine, double click, and we will choose retrieve machine from library. Okay, mill. So, okay. Now we have all these types of machine. We will use three axis vertical. Vertical means that it will be vertical, three axis x, y, z only. Okay. So, okay. This is the we can use part. We will explain by the details. It's okay. I used the axis to be in the center. Okay. This is the equipment or the machine. And I can click OK. This is the machine with the part. And if you see here, this is the tools that we use. And this is the head vertical, as we know. And we can make simulation, not verification, simulation. We can go to workpiece, select workpiece, and then make simulate machine. Simulate machine, show 3D material removal, and then make play. You will see what happened here. Also, this is the code. If you notice here, this is the code x, y, z, and this is the coordinates. And now you can rotate also. You can rotate and make to see what happened. If the cutting move is okay, or we have problem, or you can detect all of this from this simulation. This is the fastest. From here you can control the speed. Okay, here in this equipment, three axis, the table is have the move. In another equipment, in another machine, you can find that the head have these moves. Okay, each machine have the specific parameters or specific moves. Okay. After it will finish the first operation, as we see, it will take the second tool to make the second operation. Okay, it's okay now because it will take some time. Here, simulate. Okay, it's okay now. We know how to make simulation for the equipment or for the machine with our board. Okay, see you next sessions. We will make some details sessions to know the more and more operations and parameters that can control the cutting and non-cutting moves. Thank you very much. See you next session.